a humble effort to do that. Please forgive my ultra generalizations. First of all, I'm thankful to the artist who sang before, such intoxicating voice. I never heard Bangladesh music through that kind of voice. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. And whenever I delivering speeches, as a habit, I do not follow any script. But again, Mr. Bandara asked me to submit my speech in advance. So I am following today a script, but definitely I will add something as exceptions. Today, Mr. Bandara and Mr. Barua has created a meeting point for Bangladeshi Sri Lankan communities. Decades ago, Rabindranath Tagore also created a meeting point somewhere in Berlin, where the Western science and the Eastern spirituality met together. He met great scientist Albert Einstein. A moment ago, we showed the slides and the first photograph of he was sitting with Einstein. And there was a big argument went on, the historic discussion of epistemology and ontology, everything. Yes. So if you have a time, please go through then that historic discussion. And the same manner, so we are again creating in the West a meeting point where we encounter the beauty, strength of Eastern spirituality. So the towering figure of that spiritual path is Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was one of the towering leaders of the India's independence struggle. But he didn't live to see an independent India. At the age of 80, he passed away in 1941, remaining a huge heritage, not only for the people of India and Bangladesh, but for the entire world. That is a world heritage. Start from poetry to politics, environment to spirituality, philosophy to arts, nationalism to internationalism or universalism, activism to relaxation. From a simple ditty to national anthems sung by millions of people. From education to enlightenment. From a dewdrop to a rain, from rain to whale, from whale to river, from river to ocean, Tagore has been an inextricable personality, an irrevocable bond, a long-lasting memory, and a cultural treasure that you can't dig up and finish in your lifetime. Above all, for me personally, Tagore is a poet. His language was figurative, expressive, and so evocative. He was known mostly for his literature works. He was the first non-European personality to win the Nobel Prize for his remarkable poetry, the Gitanjali. When Mr. Bandara asked me to say a few words in this gathering, I was compelled to reread Gitanjali again. So thank you, Mr. Bandar, for that. He wrote novels, to name one, Gora. Essays, short stories, dramas, and many thousand songs. Some of them we heard a moment ago. Thousand songs. They were rhythmic. Not only songs, even novels were rhythmic. Prose, short stories, all had a rhythmic style. And they were philosophical, progressive, spiritual, and simple. He had unlimited devotedness for humankind, especially for ordinary people. To quote